Reduce ping in games with no ping, link in the description below. In the first method, you will disable Fullscreen optimizations. In Ghostrunner 2, first, you need to find the installation path of the game. To do this, open Ghostrunner 2, then press Windows and G on the keyboard to minimize it. Now, right-click on the taskbar and then click on Task Manager. Now, select the Details section. Then, under this search bar in the upper corner, type Ghostrunner 2. Now, right-click on Ghostrunner 2-win64-shipping.exe and then click on Open File Location. After that, click on the address bar in the upper corner. Then you will see the drive letter where your Ghostrunner 2 is installed. Write it down because you will need it for the sixth method. Now find the Ghostrunner 2-win64-shipping file. Then right click on it. Now click on Properties. After that, select the Compatibility tab. Now check the box under Disable Fullscreen Optimizations, and lastly, you can save the change by clicking Apply and OK. In the second method, you will enable optimized graphic settings and set the high performance GPU preference for Ghostrunner 2. First, click on the Windows icon. Now, in the search bar, type graphic settings. After that, click on the corresponding option. Now, make sure that optimizations for Windows games is enabled. Then, click on Advanced Graphics Settings to expand it. Now, make sure that Hardware Accelerated GPU Scheduling is enabled. And then disable the variable refresh rate option. Now under search this list, type Ghostrunner 2. Once you find Ghostrunner 2, click on it to expand the other options. Then under GPU preference, select high performance. And lastly, make sure that optimizations for Windows games is enabled. In the third method, you will set the high performance power plan. To do this, click on the Windows icon. Now in the search bar, type powercfg.cpl. After that, click on the corresponding option. Now, if you have your processor chipset driver installed, you will notice its power plans. If you don't have the chipset driver for your processor installed, I will leave a link in the description below to the AMD and Intel website where you can download and install the chipset driver. After that, you need to select the high performance power plan from your processor. In my case, I have an AMD processor, so I will select AMD Ryzen High Performance. And lastly, if after installing the chipset driver, your processor's power plan doesn't appear, you can select the Windows default High Performance Power Plan. In the fourth method, you will create a DWORD value in Regedit to make the Ghostrunner 2 process run at high priority permanently. First, click on the Windows icon. Now, in the search bar, type Regedit. After that, click on the corresponding option. Under this field, you will need to paste the address that I will leave in the description below. Now press Enter on the keyboard to access it. After that, you should right-click on the Image File Execution Options key, then click on New and Key. Now you will name this key the same as the Ghostrunner 2 process, which is Ghostrunner2-win64-shipping.exe, and then press Enter on the keyboard to save it. Now right-click on the key that you've created, then click on New and Key. After that, name this key as Perf Options and then press Enter on the keyboard to save it. Now you must right click on the Perf Options key and then click on New and DWORD 32-bit value. After that, you will see a new DWORD value in the upper corner, then name it as CPU Priority Class and then press Enter on the keyboard to save it. Now right click on the CPU Priority Class DWORD value and then click on Modify. And lastly, inside of its data, you will type 3 to set high priority and then click on OK to save it. In the fifth method, you will enable game mode. To enable it, click on the Windows icon. Now in the search bar, type game mode. After that, click on the corresponding option. And lastly, make sure that game mode is enabled. In the sixth message, it will optimize the drive where Ghostrunner 2 is installed. To do this, click on the Windows icon. Now in the search bar, type DFRGUI. After that, click on the corresponding option. Now you should select the drive where Ghostrunner 2 is installed. You can find out by following the steps in the first method. And lastly, after selecting the drive, click on Optimize to optimize it. In the seventh method, it will optimize the NVIDIA graphics settings. First, right-click on the desktop, then click on Show More Options, and then NVIDIA Control Panel. After that, select the Manage 3D Settings section. Now look for Low Latency Mode, and then set it to Ultra to decrease the input latency. Then look for Power Management Mode, and then set it to Prefer Maximum Performance. If you want to learn more about each of these NVIDIA options, I will leave a link to a video in the cards and in the description below. And lastly, you must save the changes by clicking on Apply in the lower right corner. In the eighth method, you will check the integrity of Windows system files and fix them if there are any issues. To do this, first right-click on the Windows icon, then you should click on Terminal Admin. After opening the terminal, you should first check and repair the Windows image file, then type /online /cleanup-image /restore-health, and then press Enter to run it. Now just wait for the process to finish. After that, you can check and repair the system files, then type /sfc /scan-now, and then press Enter again to run it. And lastly, you just need to wait for the process to finish. In the ninth method, you will set the most optimized graphics settings in Ghostrunner 2. First, open Ghostrunner 2. Now click on Settings and Video. Then make sure that Window Mode is set to Full Screen. Now we will test the performance impact of the following graphics settings. If your priority is to achieve the highest possible frame rate, FPS, make the following changes. If you want to increase GPU usage, then make the following changes. If you're playing on a laptop or want to reduce GPU usage, make the following changes. So let's compare the three different ways to configure graphics settings in Ghostrunner 2. And that was the video. Let me know in the comment section below if this video was helpful to you. If you want to boost and optimize performance in other games, you can subscribe to this channel and then always learn new methods when I upload new videos. Thanks for watching, see you in the next video.